Reproduction is a fundamental feature of all living organisms. Organisms exhibit two major modes of reproduction, asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction involving a single parent usually takes place by amitotic or mitotic division. Widespread, it is seen in organisms. In animals, there are four major types of asexual reproduction. They are fission, budding, fragmentation, and regeneration. Fission is the division of the parent body into two or more identical daughter individuals. Five types of fission are seen: binary fission, multiple fission, sporulation, strobilation, and plasmotomy. In binary fission, the parent organism divides into two by means two. So it divides into two halves, and each half forms a daughter individual. The nucleus first divides, and that is called as karyokinesis mitotically, and then it is followed by the division of the cytoplasm, cytokinesis. Based on the plane of division, binary is, again, we can see four types of binary fission: simple binary fission, transverse binary fission, longitudinal fission, and oblique binary fission. These are the four main types. Simple binary fission, example we are seeing in amoeba. This is a microscopic picture. In amoeba, the contractile vacuole, when the amoeba, this is very hard to see the plane of division in amoeba. Contractile vacuole disappears and the nucleus divides mitotically into two, and two daughter cells or two daughter amoeba are formed. The other one we are seeing is transverse binary fission, as we are seeing in paramecium. The division axis is transverse. Here in paramecium, the parent cell or the mother cell, there are two nucleus, macronucleus and the micronucleus. Macronucleus divides amitotically and micronucleus divides mitotically to form two daughter paramecia. Two types of binary fission we are seeing in this picture. Here we are seeing longitudinal binary fission based on the plane of the division in euglena. The nucleus and the cytoplasm, they divide in the longitudinal axis of the organism, giving rise to two new euglena. The basal granule, it divides into two and forms two different flagella for two different these daughter individuals. In oblique binary fission, we are seeing the example of ceratium. The plane of division is oblique in ceratium. This type of fission is oblique binary fission. Multiple fission, here the parent body divides into many small daughter individuals. Here the parent body, it divides into many small daughter individuals. The nucleus first divides without the division of the cytoplasm, as we are seeing here. And then later on, each nucleus is surrounded by a cytoplasmic part and each one acts an individual. So this type of multiple fission is seen in Vorticella. Here we are seeing strobilation. This is a mature Aurelia, and here this is a special type of transverse fission. Here this transverse fission takes place, and each by this strobilation, this is called a strobilation, and then each transverse fission, it will form a new individual, but they do not separate out immediately. Later on only, here we are seeing the picture of a young ephedra larva detaching from the parent plant, and then this is a detached part, and then this gives rise to a mature Aurelia. So this is a special type of transverse fission, which is called as a strobilation, as we are seeing here in Aurelia. Plasmotomy is the division of multinucleated parent into multinucleated daughter individuals, as we are seeing here in the picture. This type of plasmotomy division is seen in Pelomyxa. Then here we are seeing sporulation. In amoeba, what happens is during unfavorable condition, amoeba multiplies by sporulation. The nucleus ruptures into many chromatin, and then the nuclear metal comes out and this forms chromatin blocks. Each of the chromatin blocks, nuclear membrane disintegrating and the nuclei coming out, and this each of the nucleus is surrounded by, each fragment develops a nuclear membrane around it. So it develops a nuclear membrane and becomes surrounded by a cytoplasm. Then when favorable condition comes, the parent body disintegrates and releases the spores. The spore case, it surrounds a spore case inside a nucleus and the cytoplasm. And in the favorable conditions, from the spore case, the each one hatches. Amoeba is hatching out. We are seeing here an amoeba hatching out. So from one parent body in the unfavorable condition, and many, so we are seeing many individuals, and they hatch out during the favorable condition. This type of fission is seen in, called sporulation, is seen in amoeba. We have learnt about fission, and now we are going to learn another mode of asexual reproduction, budding. Near budding, the parent body produces one or more buds, and then each bud grows into a new individual. If the bud grows outside on the outer surface of the parent body, as we are seeing here in Hydra, it will be called as an exogenous budding. And if the buds, if they are formed inside the parent body, as we are seeing here in Noctiluca, these buds, each bud will remain in the parent body, and then it is going to give rise to a new individual. So if the buds are formed inside the parent body, this is called as endogenous budding. Fragmentation, another mode of asexual reproduction we are seeing here in sea anemone. Sea anemone, from the bottom, that it's pedal part. Therefore, this process is also called as pedal laceration. Its pedal part, the lobes are formed. It constricts out from the parent body. That is a fragment. A piece is constricted out, and then it grows into a new individual, growing the tentacle. Sea anemone in sea anemone. Then one more type of fragmentation, as we are seeing in tapeworm. This is the anterior end of the tapeworm, and this is the posterior end. From the posterior end, the mature proglottids, the parts of the tapeworm, they separate out, a fragment out, either singly or in groups. And this type of separating out, a fragmenting of the proglottids from the posterior end, is called as a apolysis. Is very significant in tapeworm, because this proglottid that contains developed embryos, they are significant in transferring the developed embryos from the primary host man to a secondary host pig. So this type of asexual reproduction is seen in tapeworm. Regeneration is regrowth in the injured region. Regeneration is of two types, morphallaxis and epimorphosis. Morphallaxis, good example is planaria. In this, the whole body grows from a small fragment. The whole body, if the whole planaria, if it gets injured, any part of the planaria is capable of giving rise to a new whole organism. So this type of regeneration is called as morphallaxis. The another one is epimorphosis. It is a replacement of the lost part. So here a small part is cut, and this is capable of this organism. Example, starfish is capable of giving rise to its lost part. This type of regeneration is called as epimorphosis.